Countless recollections tell us of the rich place of music in Jewish lives through the ages, even in times of despair. And the violin has been at the heart of Jewish life for reasons that are partly spiritual, partly practical. The Center for Holocaust Education and Scholarship is pleased to welcome tonight Mr. Niv Ashkenazi, a virtuoso and classically trained violinist. Praised for both his, quote, lush sound and passionate playing, as well as his formidable technical powers. He is an active soloist and chamber musician who has performed in Europe, the Middle East, and across the United States, including at the Kennedy Center and Carnegie Hall. Highlights of Mr. Ashkenazi's past season include an appearance as a guest artist at La Sierra University and a residency with the Perlman Music Program performing on the Violins of Hope in Sarasota, Florida. Mr. Ashkenazi's solo appearances include work with the Los Angeles Doctors Symphony Orchestra and the California State University Northridge Orchestra. As a chamber musician, he has collaborated with members of the Los Angeles Philharmonic, Juilliard String Quartet, Cavani Quartet, and Ariel Quartet. Mr. Ashkenazi holds both a Bachelor of Music and a Master's of Music from the Juilliard School, where he was a student of Yitzhak Perlman and Glenn Dichterow. Tonight, Mr. Ashkenazi will perform on a Violin of Hope, one of scores of violins played during the Holocaust by Jews who were forced to play under unimaginable conditions in ghettos, forest hideouts, and concentration camp orchestras. Playing those violins helped those musicians survive. About 60 violins that survived the ashes of the Holocaust were lovingly refurbished by Mr. Amnon Weinstein in Israel. Ladies and gentlemen, you are about to hear the premier recital on a Violin of Hope in Canada.
Here with one of the Violins of Hope. And Violins of Hope is an organization run by Amnon Weinstein and his son Avshi. And what they do is they collect and restore instruments that have gone through the Holocaust. They then bring these instruments all over the world and have musicians perform on them as part of concerts as well as educational programs to bring continued awareness and education about the Holocaust. Thank you. the early mandates in Nazi Germany in 1933 was not to allow Jews to play the music of the great German composers such as Bach, Beethoven, Mozart, and Wagner. The Nazis thought that in order to restore their musical supremacy, Jews had to stop playing this music. They also didn't allow what they called degenerate music, such as jazz, atonal music, and music by Jewish composers such as Mendelssohn and Mahler. There were many Jews in the orchestras in Germany at the time, especially in the string sections. There was a noticeable change and decline in the numbers of players after the mandate came into place. One of the ways Amnon views the importance of playing on these violins of hope is that Jews and their music were silenced. But we're here today having Jews and people of all nationalities and religions playing these instruments and playing music by both German and non-German composers. I will now play for you the Adagio from Bach's Sonata No. 1 in G minor. It is part of a set of 6 solo sonatas and partitas for solo violin, and they're considered some of the greatest music composed. Thank you. Violins of Hope collection has a story. And for a few, we have very detailed knowledge of who owned the instrument and what they endured during the war. But the vast majority, we don't have such details. And this seems fitting, in a way, with the rest of the Holocaust. There are many stories that we know of, that people have shared, and we must continue to share these stories and keep them alive. But there are many millions more that we don't know their stories. We can piece together what their lives may have been like and what horrors they may have faced, but we will never truly know. And this violin is like one of the ones that we don't quite know all the details for. What we do know is that it came to Amnon's shop from America, and that the person who owned it survived and went to America. But beyond that, we don't know much. It was one of the first instruments Amnon restored, and it is a good quality instrument. It was built probably near Yugoslavia in the early 1900s, and probably went to a family of means. It has a beautiful Star of David on the back, made out of abalone shell. And this is one of the things that didn't need any restoration. It was common practice during the time before the war to have these violins hung up on the walls, and that was because in Orthodox tradition, you aren't allowed to have representative art, but violins were allowed. And so these Stars of David were proudly displayed with the violin facing the back facing out. And what you may notice is that the back is actually lighter than the front. And that is because what happened was the sun would come in through the window and would hit the back of the violin. And you can actually see where that was. I got involved with Violins of Hope in early 2016 when I was invited to perform on their instruments in Sarasota, Florida. We went there to 1 to 2 schools each day to talk and play with the students, talk and play for the students, I should say, and then had a public concert each evening. Hearing the stories of each violin and the horrors witnessed and experienced by the owners of each instrument brings up many emotions, and sometimes it actually makes it very difficult to play on these violins. I felt a deeper connection both to the instrument and the former owner because this was that person's voice. Each violin sounded and felt unique, and each had endured tremendous trauma. And it has been an honor getting to play on these instruments and giving them a new voice. I'd like now to play for you Nigun by Bloch. Thank you. If you guys would like to know more about music and its place during the Holocaust, there's a great book by James A. Grimes called Violin of Hope that was written in collaboration with Amnon. And before I go, I'd like to finish off with one more song, which is Dance of the Rebbetzin by George Perlman.
Very much, Niv, for that very moving performance on A Violin of Hope. The sounds that echoed in this synagogue tonight will resonate with us for many, many years. We also want to thank Amnon Weinstein, who lives in Tel Aviv, for his painstaking work restoring the violins that survived the Holocaust and for bringing them back to concert quality, allowing us to enjoy their music again while remembering the violinists who survived the war playing them under unthinkable conditions.